There have been recommendations that if people are sensitive to air conditions, to stay inside, but no shelter in place right now has been ordered. And John, if you can hear me, we'll try again.
I can hear you.
Okay.
So I've been in contact with Contra Costa Hazardous Materials Division and the Bay Area Air Quality Management District, and I did also speak with Chevron. According to our Hazardous Materials Division, there was a problem in the de-asphalting unit at the refinery, which caused the need for this emergency flaring. This is not normal flaring. This is emergency flaring. And it's done in order to minimize the risk of something worse happening. And the result of that were that gases were released through four flares. The Hazardous Materials Division tells me that the flaring event has stopped and that there were hydrocarbons, carbon dioxide, particulate matter, and other yet-to-be-determined compounds that were released. And they had inspectors on site monitoring the community fence line monitors. They determined that due to the wind conditions, there was not a need to have a shelter in place. They will continue to monitor that, and we'll know more as the evening goes on.
John, I know you remember the 2012 Chevron fire. 10,000 to 15,000 people needed treatment then. Is there a concern with the refinery so close to so many people that this emergency flaring took place? Again, not something that happens all the time.
Well, obviously, any time there are hazardous materials released in the air, those always have the potential to pose health risks. Then it's determined what individual sensitivities are, how close they are, what the wind conditions are. So it is never safe or healthy to have this type of release. According to our hazardous materials and health department, they did not make a determination to have shelter in place because they were monitoring the fence line monitors and did not see anything at the ground level. That does not mean that there were not hazardous materials in the air. So that will be further analyzed, I'm sure, by the Hazardous Materials and Health Division during the course of the evening. They did just tell me that the gases and smoke were beginning to dissipate as the flaring ended, but that doesn't mean there isn't still materials in the air.
Again, the gases were coming out of four flares earlier tonight when this started a couple hours ago, down to one flare before we talked. And John, you're now saying that the flaring is out and that the gases will continue to subside. When do you think the potential problem for folks who might be sensitive to air quality issues, when do you think the problem will be over for them?
Hazardous material inspectors are out in the field. They're going to continue to monitor and I am told, again, that the flaring itself has ended, but that doesn't mean that there are not still hazardous materials in the air. But, again, they will continue to monitor to determine if a shelter in place is necessary and have not determined that one is necessary right now.
All right, John Goy, Supervisor, Contra Costa County, we greatly appreciate your time tonight and your information. Again, the incident at the Chevron refinery in Richmond, emergency flaring. The flaring is now out, but that does not necessarily mean that the gases are no longer coming out. So we'll continue to monitor this situation and have updates for you throughout the evening on air and online, cron4.com. Pam.